We're gathered here on the Leonardtown's fine wharf. There's no boats here, but the Coast Guard. They want to chase everybody out. No, anyway, we're celebrating a National Safe Boating Week. Whereas on average, 600 people die each year in boating-related accidents in the U.S. 79% of these are fatalities caused by drowning. And whereas the vast majority of these accidents are caused by human error or poor judgment and not by the boat, equipment, or environmental factors. And whereas a significant number of boaters who lose their lives by drowning each year would be alive today had they worn their life jackets. Now, therefore, we, the Commissioner of St. Mary's County, do hereby support the goals of the Safe Boating Campaign and proclaim May 20th through 26th, 2023, a National Safe Boating Week and the start of the year-round effort to promote safe boating.
Clap, clap. All right. Thank you. Thank you.
Another comment, both my wife and I, we have a sailboat, we have a powerboat, and we always wear our life vest before we even get on the dock.
Excellent.
We put it on. Got those inflatable guys, you know, that supposedly are supposed to inflate when you hit the water. I hope they work. I don't know. But we haven't tested one yet. So
I'm George Weston, and I'm the flotilla commander for the Coast Guard Auxiliary Solomon's Flotilla. I'm really pleased to be here today. Beautiful Leonardtown Wharf on Breton Bay. Mayor, thank you. Beautiful location. And to celebrate National Safe Boating Week and to briefly talk to you about boating safety and on our Southern Maryland waters. First, I want to thank Mr. Randy Guy, our President of the Commissioners, and all the commissioners who are here supporting National Safe Boating Week. And Mayor Dan Burris, I'd like to thank you as well for coming down here for this. I especially like to thank our local Coast Guard Station St. Inigo's folks for coming down. Really appreciate you guys doing this to support this National Safe Boating Week. So,
thank you
for all your support.
The Coast Guard motto is Semper Paratus, always ready. And Station St. Inigo's personnel are always ready. They are, you may not be aware, they have four response boats down there that are ready 24/7, 365 days a year to support us in any problems that happen on the water. I'd also like to thank my own flotilla members for coming down here to support this as well. As the uniformed volunteer component of the Coast Guard, they do all kinds of boating safety efforts, public affairs and things, and patrols on the water even, and all at zero pay. Do you know what the top three boating factors are that contribute to boating accidents? They're operator inattention, operator inexperience, and improper lookout when they're out on the water. Together, those three things contributed to almost half of all boating accidents. So how do we mitigate those factors? Well, one way is through boater education. Boating education really does save lives. 74% of boating fatalities in 2022 occurred with people with no boating safety education in their background. Strikingly, only 2% of the deaths occurred to people who had gotten boating safety training from the Coast Guard Auxiliary, the Power Squadron, or the Red Cross. Only 2%. Because of this, our flotilla maintains a really strong public education effort. We teach boating safety at the local county libraries. We teach it at the various marinas, Solomon's Island Yacht Club. We do a monthly class there. So we're pretty active in doing that. We also teach the Maryland DNR boating safety course for people to get their boating license. So the proclamation mentioned the importance of wearing a life jacket. The number one cause of deaths in recreational boating is drowning. In 2022, 85% of people who drowned were not wearing a life jacket. 85%. We should all remember that a life jacket not worn on your boat is like an unfastened seatbelt in your car. It doesn't help you when you have an accident. You don't have it if it on. I wanted to mention the 2023 Operation Dry Water is going to take place at 4th of July weekend. It was a month or so away still, but there's going to be increased heightened awareness and enforcement on the waters during that weekend to help keep down these accidents. So I'm going to close with some good news. The Coast Guard reports from 20 to 22, 2 years, the total number of boating deaths decreased by 17%. The total number of boating accidents decreased by 23%, and the number of non-fatal injury victims decreased by 30%. So we're doing something right. We're doing something right. So your Coast Guard Auxiliary and your active duty Coast Guard are working hard to keep things together. Thanks everybody for supporting boating safety.
Thank you, Mr. West. Thank you for your group and what you do for us. Thank you.
You're welcome.